Here, already we know, first of all, how the verbal situation, how to convert as mathematical equation, already we learned. Okay. Next, the cost of a book is equal to X rupees, the cost of a pen is equal to Y rupees, total amount paid as 50 rupees. So that mathematical equation is X plus Y is equal to 50, which is a pair of linear equation in two variables. Next, we are going to think about what is the cost of one notebook and what is the cost of one pen. Can you able to say, Nana? Example, one of the students says book cost is and pen cost. He can imagine one book cost is equal to 10 rupees means automatically pen cost is equal to 40 rupees because the total we want to get 50 rupees. Is it clear? And next, if another boy assumed as the book cost is 5 rupees means it is 45 rupees. This is 20 rupees means this is 30 rupees. It is 40 rupees means this is 10 rupees. So, how many such type of answers we have to expect? Once imagine, Nana, if it is 1 rupee, that is 49 rupees. This is 10 paisa. Example, if it is 10 paisa, and that is 49 rupees 90 paisa. So, how many answers we can able to expect? Means, infinite many answers we have to expect. So that for every linear equation, how many solutions we have to expect means infinite many solutions we can expect. Is it clear for all? In 9th class, already we learned about this. Clear, Nana? We get infinite solutions for every linear equation in two variables. So that we need one more linear equation. Means if we have pair of linear equation in two variables, means two linear equations are there, means we have to compare with that two, we can able to find out a unique solution. That is, when we have the two linear equations are there, means we can expect a unique solution. Have you understood, children? Okay, children, suppose we analyze some examples. Children, how the pair of linear equation we have to get, when we get a unique solution, once we check. Example, just a little bit earlier, whatever we take the example, that only I am taking. One boy went to the shop and he brought one pen and one book. One book and one pen, he paid as 50 rupees. Same example I am taking now. Here, the cost of a book is equal to X and the cost of a pen is equal to Y rupees and paid rupees 50 rupees 10. Okay, this equation, how can we write in mathematical means X plus Y is equal to 50. Okay, clear? X plus Y is equal to 50. Okay, simply I am assuming little bit. Example, book costs 30 rupees. Okay, book costs 30 rupees. Simply I am example, X is equal to 30 and Y is equal to automatically 20 rupees. Simply we are assuming and we check once. So, X plus Y is equal to 30. We just roughly I noted, but here we are thinking I don't know the value of X and Y, right? And I am taking another here, the cost of one book is and one pen is equal to 50 rupees. I am taking another example, two pens cost, so two books and three pens. How much we have to expect for our example? 230 is 60. 320 is 60. The total amount is 120 rupees. 60 plus 60, 120. Yes, here 230 is 60. And 320 is 60, 120 rupees. Okay. Here, for another example, this is example second. And in the example third, I am checking. The another boy went to the shop and he bought
What's the two books and three, sorry, two pens, and he paid us 100 rupees. Is it clear? So two books and two pens. He paid us 100 rupees. Okay. But in another boy went to the shop. He bought two books and two pens, but he paid us 120 rupees. Okay, I am taking these three examples. Once they are going to check how to find the answer. Here x plus y is equal to 50. I am taking if x is subject means x is equal to 50. This plus y shift to the right side means it become as minus y. This asterisk you shift in this question. How many? 2. At the place of x we got 50 minus y plus 3y is equal to 120. So 250 is 100 children. This is 2y plus 3y is equal to 120. 100 okay. 3y minus 3y minus 2y we get 1y is equal to 120. And y is equal to 120 minus 100. So y is equal to 20 rupees. Y means what we assume now? It is pen cost. Clear? We got 20 rupees. And how I get the book cost? This y is equal to 20 shift at the place of this first equation. Means x is equal to 50 minus 20. Then you get answer is how much? 30 rupees. You clearly got the unique answer. The cost of book is equal to 30 rupees. The cost of pen is equal to 20 rupees. We got the unique solution. Sir, when we got the unique solution, here one condition is there. That is, once clearly check this condition, listen carefully. What happened is, here these coefficients we treated, this is a1 and this is the b1. The coefficient second equation, this is a2 and this is b2. When I am taking as a1 by a2 is equal to, I get here 1 is the coefficient, here 2 is the coefficient, 1 by 2, and same one, b1 by b2 is equal to, I have 1, sir. But then 3. Then what happened here? A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. When it is follows this condition, means A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, then only we get unique solution. Otherwise, we cannot get unique solution. If it is follows this condition, we treat it as these equations are called consistent equations. What do we call it? Consistent equation. Why? Because we get the answer. These equations are called independent equations. What we call independent equations. These equations we get unique solution. Only one solution. Next, if we go through by the graphical representation, that graphical lines, when we draw these two lines in the graph, that lines must be intersect each other at one point. So your graphical representation, we get that lines must be intersect at one point. Okay? If you go through by the graphical means. If you get this answer, if you go like this, this we get my answer. Also, I will explain afterwards this is. This is the graphical representation. Okay, once check the conditions, Nana. Once again, if A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, we have to say they are the independent equations, they are the consistent equation, they have unique solution, and the graphical representation, they are intersecting at one point. They are the intersecting lines, enough. Right. Clear, Nana. Okay, now I am going to compare. Sorry, 50 rupees. Okay, now I am going to compare the second question. Okay, how? Same way I am doing, sir. X is equal to 50 minus y. This 50 minus y, same as this, like this, we have substituting 2 of at the place of x, 50 minus y plus 2y is equal to 100. Then 250 is 100 minus 2y plus 2y is equal to 100. So plus 2y minus 2y cancel, we get 100 is equal to 100. But we cannot get x value and y value. Y means if just we are reduced to double, that's a 2x, 2y is equal to automatically 100 means it is not a pair. It is when we cancel 2 ones are 2, 2 ones are 2, 50. So as this question we got x plus y is equal to 50. That's why for these equations we get infinite many solutions. Infinite many solutions if we get like this equal. Means how to check the condition? Once you check the condition, see the condition. Sir, here a1 by a2. Okay, here a1, here 1, here 2, 1 by 2. Okay, what about b1 by b2? B1 by b2 is equal to, here b1 is 1, here b2 is 2, 1 by 2 only. What about c1 by c2? Here 50, there 100. If we cancel, 5 1s are 5 2s, 1 by 2. So what happened? Means a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. When these all are equal means such type of equations are called consistent equations. Like first one, consistent equations only means we get our solutions. But how many solutions? Infinite many solutions. That's why these equations are called dependent equations, not independent. Dependent equations and graphical representation, when we drawn in the graph, the two lines are coincide each other. Means coincide means in the how many intersecting points? Infinite intersecting points. Coincide means so infinite solutions we have to expect for this condition. Clear, Nana? Okay, second condition also, yeah, I understand anything. What about third condition? See that third condition. That again same way, Nana, x is equal to 50 minus y. This 50 minus y substitute 2 off at the place of x, 50 minus y plus 2y is equal to 120. And then after 100 minus 2y plus 2y is equal to 120. So what happened? 100 is equal to 120. Is it true? 100 is equal to how? 100 is equal to 120? So such type of equations having no solution. We cannot get answer. Okay? These equations are called inconsistent equations. Check the condition once. A1 by A2 is equal to what we got, sir? Here 1 by 2. And B1 by B2 is equal to what, sir? 1 by 2 only. And C1 by C2 is equal to what, sir? 50 by 120. So 5 by 12. So what happened? A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2. If it is follows this condition, if any two equations are follow this condition, such equations having no solution, such type of equations we call as inconsistent equations. Okay, their graphical representation, that two lines are parallel to each other. Clear, Nana? Okay, right. So how many cases arise for the two pair of linear equation, two variables? Means first condition is a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. One of this condition is arises. And second condition is a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. This is one of the condition. And third condition arise, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2. We have to expect these three type of conditions are arises. If first condition arises, that equations having unique solution, consistent equations, independent equations. If this condition is arises, the two equations are having infinite many solutions. Infinite many solutions. They are consistent equations. They are dependent equations. If this third condition is arises, means it has no solution. It has no solution. They are called the inconsistent equation. These two are the consistent equations. That is called the inconsistent equations. When check the graphical representation, these two lines are intersecting. If you draw in the graph intersecting, these two lines are coincide and these two lines are parallel lines. Are you understand, Nana? This is the introduction. Next video onwards, check, go through by the exercises.